Hello, hello! My name is Callista, and welcome back to Mass Effect Legendary Edition. In the last episode, we completed Vermeier. Ashley unfortunately got caught up in the blast of the nuke, so we are down one teammate permanently. Ashley will be missed. I didn't like her. I didn't like her in the slightest, but she had the best writing out of all of the companions, potentially out of all of the characters in this game. So I will miss her. Now then, before we do anything, I want to go and have a chat with all of our companions, make sure they're doing okay. I mean, it feels a little silly to say that, because I mean, of course they're not. Of course then. I mean, I could see Rex being okay. I could see Rex maybe not caring, but I would imagine that everyone else will have some kind of emotional response.
Commander, I know it couldn't have been easy for you down there. Making the call between Alenko and Williams must have been... I'm sorry, ma'am. I just don't know if I could have done it.
Yeah. Yeah. Pray you never have to make that choice.
There is no right choice for something like that. I just hope I never have to go through it again.
No, I'm not blaming you, Commander. I'm just... I mean, it's hard, you know?
Saren's still out there, Joker. Hold it together. We need you.
Don't worry, I won't let you down. I want to be there when you make that son of a bitch pay.
I know I've been very empathetic towards Saren recently, and I don't... I hope you don't think that I'm saying that Naomi is suddenly like, oh my god, Saren, he was never a bad guy. He was a good guy. None of this is his fault. Like, no, she's like, A, he destroyed Eden Prime. He's responsible for Ashley's death. However, in a way, he is a victim of Sovereign's manipulation, and I can feel pity, I can feel empathy. He still deserves to face the repercussions of his actions. He absolutely deserves to face some kind of prison sentence or whatever. He should still be brought to justice. However, this wasn't completely his fault. This is not a black or white issue. This is very deep shades of gray. He may not have been completely in control of his actions. He is being manipulated and he can't even see that he is being manipulated. I can feel badly, but I can also still be quite miffed that, you know, he fucked up the colony and Ashley is dead because of him. Like, this is, it's not a black and white issue.
I'll be okay, Commander. Just need some time.
Okay. Okay, that was a nice conversation. I'm glad we got that. Joker... I'm not glad he's upset. That sounded a bit psychotic. I'm not glad he's upset, but I'm glad that we're getting to see him emote, because... Joker, like... He's always there, but he doesn't really have much to say, so I'm... You know, moments like that, it makes him feel like he's part of the crew. I really appreciate that.
Anything you need, Commander?
Yeah, how are you feeling about Williams?
I wanted to see how you're dealing with Ash's death.
Dealing, ma'am. Sorry for anything I said back there. Adrenaline.
I understand. I don't like losing people either.
I've served for years, but never lost a soldier under my command. Not to hostile action, anyway. If you don't mind my asking, how did you deal with the losses on Akuz?
I mean, did she deal with the losses on Akuz? Did she deal with them? I think... Here's the thing. I think Naomi carries those people everywhere she goes. They're always there in the back of her mind. Even Toomes. She may know that Toomes is now alive, but he suffered because she didn't realize that he was alive. She thought, oh shit, he's dead. Everyone's dead. I've got to run. Like, she didn't realize he was still alive. So his suffering is on her too. I think she carries them with her everywhere. I guess that they did their duty and I grieved later. She's still grieving. She's still grieving. She still has trauma relating to Akuz. I think this one sums up her feelings best. You know, she carries them with them. She carries them with her to remember in the hopes that she will do better. She won't be in that situation again.
It was my job to get everyone out safe. I failed. I vowed not to let that happen again. Same here. I'll remember her, and I'll do better for her.
Yeah, I guess that's all we can do. Thanks for the advice, ma'am.
Just trying to get a sense of where the crew's at. Thoughts?
We're all in for the duration. You can count on everyone to do their duty.
What's your opinion on the last mission?
Input? Hell, I don't know. We're fighting giant machines from outside the galaxy. Should I be afraid of them? Or in awe of them? Anything so old, so intelligent.
I mean, I'd vote fear, personally. I mean, you know, fear keeps you respectful. It keeps you on your toes. And, yeah, we need to be on our toes here. We don't want to underestimate these things. Sorry about the cut there. I just had to reload this. So I went with they're old all right. And the response from Shepard is, yeah, they're old, but so was the Turians. And we stuck our boot right up their ass. And I did not like that for Naomi. I didn't like that for her because to be brutally honest, I don't think that Naomi really cares about military history. She doesn't come from a military family. She didn't join the army because she has respect for soldiers and servicemen. She joined the army because it was like, A, I can die in the slums, or I can die doing something decent. So I'll die doing something decent. She doesn't really care about military history. So this, you're like, oh, we stuck the boot up the Turian's ass. It just didn't fit her personality. It didn't suit how I see her. So I had to reload it. It just didn't sit right with me. I guess hopeful.
We may be ants to them, but humans have never managed to exterminate ants.
It makes you wonder, are ants any more aware than we were of the giants that walk over their heads?
I love that. I love that, because if you remember from her backstory, something that when she joined the army and, you know, she was just some, you know, kid from the gutter. She was no one. People used to call her a cockroach because she was so far beneath them. That's what they called her. And she has since taken that. And it's because here's the thing. It's, you know, you'd struggle to kill cockroaches. You cut off their head. They're still running around. They're still running around. Cockroaches are survivors. Cockroaches are survivors. So what was an insult she has taken and she now wears it as a badge of pride? Yeah, I'm a cockroach. I'm a fucking survivor. Deal with it. Go fuck yourselves. So I like the insect analogy there. I like her using an insect analogy. I like that. I like that.
We'll talk another time, Lieutenant.
Very glad I reloaded that. Very happy. And ChatQuest, we just had a crew member die. Do you have anything?
Yes, Commander. Is there something you need?
I wish ChatQuest were more involved. If they could give lines to Joker, then they could give lines to ChatQuest.
I should go.
Goodbye, Commander.
Hello.
Commander, are you coming to check up on me?
You look much better. How are you feeling?
Dr. Chakwas assures me I am going to be fine. I was impressed with her knowledge of Asari physiology.
I swear, this is like the third time we've heard this dialogue.
You're in good hands. Dr. Chakwas knows what she's doing.
I've been thinking about Saren. I actually feel a little sorry for him now.
Thank you. I was genuinely concerned that the game was gonna push, like, oh, Shepard feels anger and nothing else towards him. I like the fact that we're getting the option to agree, like, oh yeah, we kind of feel badly for him. Oh, thank you, game. Thank you.
He's become a slave to the Reapers and he can't even see it.
He is trapped inside his own mind. Part of him senses his identity slowly being swallowed up by Sovereign, but he is powerless to stop it. I wonder how he first fell into Sovereign's trap. Did he think he could somehow stop the Reapers from returning? Or was he simply driven by a lust for power and glory?
I mean, we didn't know the guy. The only story we have about him is from Anderson. And here's the thing, whilst Naomi deeply respects Anderson, she deeply respects him. She looks up to him a lot. He is also very clearly biased. And I think Naomi, she's not so blinded by respect that she wouldn't be able to see that he's biased. She does believe the story he told her was factual. She believes that, but it was also very emotive. I've said this before, there is a big difference between being ruthless and getting the job done and wanting to destroy the galaxy. And he claims he's doing this because, you know, oh, if I can prove I'm useful, then maybe the Reapers will keep some of us alive. Like, he could be bullshitting himself. He could be trying to, you know, paint himself in the best light in his own mind so he doesn't have to deal with the shit he's done. Like, I don't think Naomi would say it was definitely to stop the Reapers, or it was definitely for lust and, you know, it was definitely because he wanted power. Like, I don't think we'll ever really know.
Whatever Saren's reasons may have been, they're long gone now. He has to be stopped.
Yes, I suppose you're right. He may be Sovereign's victim, but he is also a threat to all life as we know it. Let's not spend every free minute talking about Saren. It is bad enough we are chasing him across the galaxy.
That's what I was trying to verbalize earlier. Saren may be Sovereign's victim, but he's still a threat. He's still done bad shit, and I'm so glad that the game is presenting me with someone who's saying the same things. Oh, I love you, Liara. I love you so much.
I should go.
Goodbye, Shepard.
Yeah, one second, though.
I get the feeling you want to ask me something, Commander.
Apparently not.
I just wanted to talk.
Of course, Shepard. What did you want to talk about?
Boo.
I should go.
Goodbye, Shepard.
Okay, bye. Bye, Liara. I'm wondering if maybe Kaiden will be the only one who actually has stuff to say about Ash. You know, they were kind of close. That's a thought. Have I... Oh god, I feel guilty for thinking this, but, Oh, hi! Hello there! I'm just thinking, did we get all of Ashley's stuff back? Or did that get exploded? I mean, obviously, in terms of game mechanics. I mean, in terms of, like, the story, obviously it got exploded in the nuke. But, like, in terms of game mechanics, did we get her equipment back? Oh, shit. Ash, oh well. Oh well.
It was an honor working with you, Commander Shepard. Despite the losses, our mission was a success. My superiors will duly honor Chief Williams for her actions. Her sacrifice has earned humanity a great deal of respect from my people.
Yeah. Like I keep saying, Naomi will miss her. She wanted to be Ash's friend.
Ash was a hell of a soldier. She knew what the risks were, but she did what she had to.
Of course. The grim reality that every soldier must accept. Rest assured, Commander, my men and I will not forget what you have accomplished here. We will leave your ship as soon as you reach your next destination. Perhaps we will have the opportunity to work together again someday.
Oh, I hope so, Kirahi. I hope so.
You have my gratitude, Commander. Most people would have left our team behind. The captain considers the mission a success. I defer to his judgment.
Uh-huh.
Let me see what you have.
You still have nothing. Okay.
Commander, things got heated back on Vermeier. You did what you had to do. I respect your choice.
I appreciate what you did, Rex. I won't forget it.
Just make sure it was worth it. Saren has to pay for what he's done.
Oh, absolutely.
We'll have him soon enough. Then he can answer for his crimes.
He'll do more than just answer if I have anything to say about it.
So long, Rex.
Shepard.
Just to double check. Excuse me, there we go.
Shepard.
Okay.
Rex?
I'll sort out equipment later. Oh, can we not? We can't even check her locker. Oh. My feels.
Shepard?
You don't have anything to say?
Commander, good to see you.
What the shit? Tali, do you have stuff to say? Like, please go?
Hey, Shepard. You need something?
God damn.
I should go.
See you later.
No one cares! Aside from, Kaiden and Joker, no one cares that Ash died. Well, they cared. Kirahi cared. Oh my god! I feel so badly for her. God damn. Okay, I guess that's that. No one really had anything to say on Ash's demise, except for the obvious people. Okay. Alrighty then, now where do we go from here? That's a thought. Where do we go from here? Yeah, it's just that. Oh. Yeah, but you were able to rescue Captain Kiri here and a few of his men before leaving them. Hey, nice. Okay. Where? Okay. Report to the council. So I guess. Yeah, I guess we have to head to the Citadel first. Okay. Now, before we do that...
I forwarded the mission update to the Citadel, Commander. We got confirmation on those reinforcements. Ambassador Udino wants us to report back to the Citadel. The Council's massing a joint species fleet to deal with Saren and his Geth.
Okay, that's... That's good, at least.
I knew they'd come around. Back to the Citadel, Joker. I want the Normandy at the head of that fleet.
Yes, ma'am.
No, there was stuff I had to do!
Good job, Shepard. Thanks to you, the Council's finally taking real action against Saren.
The Ambassador is correct. If Saren is foolish enough to attack the Citadel, as you believe, we will be ready for him.
Patrols are stationed at every mass relay linking Citadel space to the Terminus systems.
Okay, I do hope that I'm able to go back to, whatever system we were just in, because I never read the planetary descriptions for those planets. If not, I'll just insert them into the LP at some point, but I'm hoping we're not kind of locked in. With respect, you're not doing enough.
You think a blockade's gonna stop him? He's on Ilos looking for the conduit right now. What are you doing about that?
Ilos is only accessible to the Mu relay, deep inside the Terminus systems, Commander. If we send a fleet in there, the only possible outcome is full-scale war.
Now is the time for discretion, Commander. Saren's greatest weapon was secrecy. Exposed, he is no longer a threat. This is over.
I just, like, if we send people after him, the only outcome is war. But if you don't send people after him, the only outcome is war with a big fuck-off living machine thing. Like, which is worse, guys? Which is worse?
Secrecy isn't his greatest weapon. The conduit is.
Saren is a master manipulator. The conduit is just a distraction from his real plan to attack the Citadel.
Because y'all are so fucking important. Nothing important happens besides you guys, of course.
Sovereign's the real threat. Saren's just a servant of the Reapers.
Only you have seen the Reapers. And then only in visions. We won't invade the Terminus systems because of a dream.
Okay, that is fair. That is fair. Again, I just... Saren required no proof. Saren required no proof, yet we do. Okay.
One ship going into the Terminus systems won't start a war. I can be discreet.
You detonated a nuclear device on Vermeer. I wouldn't call that discreet.
Your style served you well in the Traverse, Commander. We recognize that. But Ilos requires a deft touch. We have the situation under control.
Hold up! Who was it who suggested the nuke? Who was it? Was it Naomi? No, it wasn't. It was the Solarians! Oh my god! Are they the deft touch y'all are talking about? I'm having a moment here. I'm having a moment.
If Saren finds the conduit, we're all screwed. We have to go to Ilos.
Ambassador Udina, I get the sense Commander Shepard isn't willing to let this go.
There are serious political implications here, Shepard. Humanity's made great gains thanks to you, but now you're becoming more trouble than you're worth.
You bastard! You're selling us out!
It's just politics, Commander. You've done your job, now let me do mine. We've locked out all the Normandy's primary systems until, for the notice, you're grounded.
Bitch!
Nobody stabs me in the back, Udina. Nobody.
I think it's time for you and your team to leave, Commander. This no longer concerns you. The Council can handle this, with my help, of course.
Commander. Shepard, I cannot believe they did this to you. I am so sorry.
Oh. I don't think Naomi can stay mad when Liara's around. Like, it wasn't you. You don't need to be the one apologizing.
It's not your fault.
It's not right. You did everything they asked and more. Nobody else could have done what you did. The Council owes you everything. Everything. Instead, they strip you of your command and ground the Normandy.
Yeah, you can't trust politicians.
I should have known better. Udina, the Council, they're all the same. Petty, blind, and stupid.
Perhaps we could appeal and get them to reverse their decision.
I pushed them as hard as I could. They wouldn't budge.
So you're going to walk away? You will just give up and doom the entire galaxy to extinction?
Not a fucking chance!
We lost the battle, not the war. I'll figure something out.
I believe in you, Shepard. I am with you every step of the way.
Sorry to interrupt, Commander. Got a message from Captain Anderson.
Oh, Naomi's in a very fragile place right now. I think under any other circumstances, I don't think she'd consider that Joker was listening in, but, right now,
Are you spying on us, Joker?
No, ma'am. Just knew you were on the ship and figured I'd pass the message on. The captain said to meet him at Flux. That club down in the wards.
You should probably go meet with him.
Okay. I guess the romance isn't over. I thought we had ended it when, you know, Liara was saying, like, hey, there's so much going on. Maybe this isn't the right moment. I assumed that the romance was over. No, it's still going. Okay. I'm drawn to these two. I'm drawn to these two because Liara can keep Naomi calm. And Kaiden's the only OG left standing, so... Yeah.
Equalizing interior pressure with exterior atmosphere. Logged. The commanding officer is ashore. Exo Presley has the deck.
Okay. Okay, now here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna weaponize the Keeper Union. That's right, they're making a comeback. I haven't spoken about them for a while, but they're making a comeback. We're gonna weaponize the Keeper Union. We're gonna give them all sniper rifles. We're gonna train them, and then we're gonna assassinate the Council. That's what we're doing.
Alliance officials report that a Geth incursion into the Armstrong cluster has been repulsed, with the Geth suffering heavy casualties. In the event of future Geth activity, the Alliance plans to maintain a strong security presence in the area.
Who repulsed those Geth? Hmm? Who did that? It was me! These hoes. Now, whilst I'm here, I'm just gonna go check to see if anyone is selling any good shit. Will you even still sell to me?
Hello, Commander.
Show me what you got.
I'll open the rare stocks for you, Commander. Enjoy.
Thank you. Wait a minute, is this... Ooh! Yes, please. Yes, please. Yeah, it is the HMWPA. Yeah, I think this is like the Spectre. The Spectre gun. Yeah, thank you. I would like the Spectre gun. That's not better than what I have. Neither is that. Don't mind me at all. I'm just loading up my arsenal. This totally isn't suspicious. So you know what, before I forget, because I will forget. Yeah. There we go. I'm totally not gonna use this gun to assassinate the Councillors. You don't need to worry about that, sir. You don't need to worry. Now then, where it was? It was Flux, right? Yeah, Flux. I mean, I could go check all of the merchants, but here's the thing, I think we've got a pretty strong team.
Alliance officials have raided a dangerous cult controlled by a former Alliance officer, Major Kyle. Major Kyle surrendered and is now being treated for severe post-traumatic stress disorder.
Yeah, and who did that? Oh yeah, it was me again. Now, you know what? I've only got about 2 minutes left on my timer, and I have noticed we have codex entries.
The Asari.
Read that, so yeah, I'm guessing. Okay. Okay, so just two. Salarians government. The Salarian government is called the Salarian Union. It is a labyrinthine web of matrilineal bloodlines with political alliances formed through interbreeding. In many ways, the Salarian political network functions like the noble families of Earth's medieval Europe. Structurally, the government consists of fiefdoms, baronies, duchies, planets, and marches, colonization clusters. These are human nicknames. The original Salarian is unpronounceable. Each area is ruled by a single Dalatress, matriarchal head of household, and represents an increasing amount of territory and prestige within the Salarian political web. Approaching 100 members, the first circle of Salarian's clan comprises parents, siblings, uncles, aunts, and cousins. The next circle includes second cousins, etc., and escalates to well over 1,000 members. The fourth or fifth circle of a clan numbers into the millions. Salarian loyalty is greatest to their first circle and diminishes from there. Their photographic memory allows Salarians... Their photographic memory allows Salarians... No, there should be a two in there. Their photographic memories allow Salarians to recognize all their myriad relatives. There we go. And Salarian's military doctrine. In principle, the Salarian military is similar to the Alliance, a small volunteer army that focuses on maneuver welfare, warfare. I'm taking a drink. I'm sorry. We've got a heat wave going on currently, and it is fucking me over so badly. Okay, there we go. In principle, the Salarian military is similar to the Alliance, a small volunteer army that focuses on maneuver warfare. What differentiates the Salarians is not their equipment or doctrine, but their intelligence services and rules of engagement. The Salarians believe that a war should be won before it begins. Conventional wisdom holds that the Salarians know everything about everyone, and this is not far from the truth. In war, the unquestioned superiority of their intelligence services allows them to use their small military to maximum effectiveness. Well before fighting breaks out, they possess complete knowledge of their enemy's positions, intentions, and timetable. In every war the Salarians have fought, they struck first and without warning. For the Salarians, to know an enemy plan to attack and to let it happen is folly. To announce their own plans to attack is insanity. They find the human moral concepts of do not fire until fired upon and declare a war before prosecuting it incredibly naive. In defensive wars, they execute devastating preemptive strikes hours before their enemy's own attacks. On the offense, they have never telegraphed their intentions with a declaration of war before attacking. Biotics are virtually unknown in the Salarian military. Those with such abilities are considered too valuable to be used as cannon fodder and are assigned to the intelligence services. While capable of defending themselves against most threats, the Salarians know that they are small fish in a universe filled with sharks. As a point of survival, they have cultivated strong alliances with larger powers, particularly with the Turians. Though the relationship between the two species was rocky at first due to the Krogan uplift fiasco, the Salarians take pains to keep this relationship strong enough that anyone who might threaten them risks Turian intervention. Okay. Yeah, and that is everything. Okay, good stuff. Yeah, okay. Okie doke. Alrighty then, I'm gonna leave this episode off right here. In the next one, we meet with Anderson in Flux. But until then, please remember to like if you enjoyed, leave a comment below, and if you wanted to subscribe, it would be very much appreciated. I've been Callista. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next episode.